Update on the government's efforts to fix the flooding problem along Ross Boulevard, as well as the repair of roads damaged by Hener. We're joined now on the line by Public Works and Highway Secretary Rogelio Singson. Secretary Singson, magandang hapon po.
Yeah, magandang hapon, Tony.
Mm-hmm. Yung pong flooding po sa Ross Boulevard, mostly a caused by a storm surge, at hindi naman po siguro dahil sa drainage problem along the road, ano?
Yeah, that's correct. talagang exceptionally high yung tide kahapon at saka nasamahan ng malakas na hangin sa dagat, no? So that's what happened yesterday.
Yes. No?
But frankly, we should be prepared for something like that happening quite often during this time of the year.
Mm-hmm. Well, we had Director Tagudando of DPWHNCR on one of our ANC programs, and we were talking to him about whether the seawall has to be raised in height to fend off bigger waves due to storm surges. He told us that the seawall has already been increased in height from 60 centimeters to 80 centimeters. Is that correct?
That's correct. What happened here was we had a long meeting with the City of Manila and Mayor Lim, no, precisely to agree on the proper height. No? So we even provided some mock-up heights, no, just to agree on how high we should bring the wall. No? Now, the option is we can raise it, and there, pero pagka nasa sasakyan ka naman, wala ka, hindi mo na makikita yung dagat, no? And I don't think we would want that, no? So ganun yung nangyari. We agreed on a certain height, pero nilagyan namin ng kurbada sa likod, no? To minimize nga yung overtopping, no? So what happened yesterday was ang malaking pinasukan ng tubig, eh hindi yung overtopping, kung hindi yung may gap kasing re-request ang City of Manila for the garbage truck to come in and clean the garbage on a regular basis, no? Dun sa gap na yon, talagang tuloy-tuloy yung agos ng tubig. Kaya yung gap na yon nasa tapat ng malapit sa Manila, sa US Embassy. Kaya dun talaga yung pasok na pasok yung tubig.
Okay. And in the meantime, do our engineers feel that that gap has to be closed or heightened?
Yes, we will have to close that. Or ang ginawa muna is provide some sandbagging, no, in that area.
Mm-hmm.
But I feel that there should be some other way of cleaning that area, no,
okay,
other than leaving that gap. Because I also went behind the. Pumunta rin ako sa likod ng US Embassy, no,
yeah,
doon sa may bandang malapit sa Quirino Grandstand.
Uh-huh.
At doon meron din mga pader na or seawall na nasira nung mga nakaraan na hindi na gagawa, no.
Mm-hmm.
Doon tuloy-tuloy din yung agos ng tubig galing sa dagat.
Okay. And we also had Director Tagudando telling us that apart from the two existing seawalls that I think are already near the area of the yacht club, I think, that there's going to be or proposed to be another seawall in between the two existing ones.
Well, that has to be discussed because we also don't want that to turn out into be another sore site, no? Pagka kung, halimbawa, nagkaroon ng mga karinderya o anong itsura niyan, ano? So we're also trying to avoid that kind of a situation.
Okay. Design of the seawall itself, do you think that it's adequate? Because there are some people who are telling us, commenting through social media, who say that the seawall should be, in effect, concave, and as a result, be able to turn the waves back towards the ocean.
Ganun na yun, eh. Concave na nga yung ilalim nun. Kaya lang, people who are talking probably have not seen what is under there.
Apo. So concave
na po siya? Concave na yun.
Okay, so
but
it actually...
You cannot do it too concave because precisely, pag ganyang kalakas ang puwersa, papasagi niya naman yun, no? Bubuwal niya yan. No?
Yes.
So you have to design the force as well as the design has to be addressed in such a way that you don't absorb the full force.
Right. Okay. It's a matter of strength of hydraulics.
Engineering na. Design na yan.
Opa. MMDA Chairman Francis Tolentino was presenting some diagrams of a proposed boardwalk or promenade along the length of Ross Boulevard. Is that a design or structure that could also help mitigate flooding along Ross Boulevard?
Well, any structure that is constructed before the seawall will dissipate the energy of that surge, no?
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, let's look at the aesthetics, no?
Yeah.
Hindi naman ganun basta-basta, let's create another wall there. Unang-una, how much will it cost? And what is the impact, no? Kasi kung sinasabi niyang may private sector na gagawa nun, paano babawiin ng private sector yung gagawin niya yun? Di maglalagay siya ng mga restaurant dyan, no? Saan, I mean, para ka nang nagpa-reclaim ulit niyan.
Parang yung dati na pong estado ng Ross Boulevard na may Baywalk, yung maraming mga establishments.
Oo nga, do we want it that way again, no? Obviously not, no?
So, you're not in favor of that idea?
No. I mean, I'm open. We can discuss it, but I guess it needs a closer look. Right? I can't just say no or yes at this time. Okay. I want to see the details.
Sige po. Bernadette.
Secretary Singson, magandang hapon po.
Yes, ma'am.
I noticed lang po kasi that a lot of discussion on at sinasabing pagpapatibay nitong seawall is along yung Camanava area and Manila. Paano naman po yung ibang areas like Cavite, yung Noveleta, yung mga tinatamaan like Ternate, Naik, all these areas na tinamaan rin naman ng mga monsoon surge yesterday. Ano ang plano naman? Is that still under your jurisdiction?
It's not under my jurisdiction, but the basic premise is there are rules on easements, no?
Mm-hmm.
These people should not be along the seawall, no? There are required easements under the water code, no? 20 meters from shoreline. Unang-una, bakit sila nandiyan? No? Ba't sila pinayagan na magtirik ng mga spills dyan sa katubigan na yan, no? I mean, and then they end up running to national government palagyan ng seawall. Alisin muna nila yung mga tao dyan siguro. Yun ang mas sa akin. Get them out of the harm's way.
Mm-hmm. Secretary Singson, nakausap kasi natin yung mga residents. Some of them are saying that they've been there for, since 1976. And it wasn't the case before. Yung dati, ang lalayo talaga ng dagat eh. Parang sinasabi nga nila, parang lumapit yung dagat. Oo, parang nilamon na yung lupa. So parang, I don't know if you're talking about easement. Obviously, I don't know if the same rule still applies since climate change is a big factor here.
Well, let's look at specific areas, no? Yung mga nagre-reklamo, no? Sa bandang Valenzuela, no? Halimbawa, yung mga portions na flooded doon, they are fish pond areas, no? Talagang, I mean, lubog talaga sila to start with, no? Maglagay ng kalye doon, no? So, siyempre, yung kaling yung pag nag-high tide, lulubog at lulubog yun, no? I don't know what they expect, no? Itataas ba namin, inaasahan na, itaas namin? O ngayon, ang lumalabas, kukulungin sila, no? Maglalagay ng seawall to protect all of the fish pond area.
Uh-huh,
no?
Uh-huh.
Now, is that environmentally correct, no?
I see. Well, obviously, it's a really major problem, not just DPWH. It's not just your problem alone. Well, good luck to all of us then. At saka DNR, lahat ng bibigyan ng mga permits dito, di ba?
Dalawa, no? Just let me explain. Dalawa yung pinanggagalingan ng baha, no? One is high tide, no? There are places where there are people that are already below sea level, no? So in other words, to start with,
nandiyan
na sila sa lubog area.
Mm-hmm,
no? other reason for the flooding is pagka nagkaroon ng malakas na ulan nanggagaling sa bundok, no, at bumababa, no. So that one, we are already trying to address that through some interventions upstream. Kasi ang problema natin pag nagsabay yung high tide at saka yung excess runoff or storm water, yun ang talagang tumatagal.
Okay. Well, Secretary Singson,
it's not an easy problem, I guess.
Oo nga po eh. Sana nga po, ano, sa darating ng mga panahon.
Dagdag mo pa yung problema sa basura, no, na nakababara dito sa mga drainage natin, no? Pero it needs everyone's effort.
Yung pong basura na inaanod po sa Manila Bay, DPWH concern pa ho ba yun? Kasi nasa dagat ho yun eh. Napunta lang sa lupa, kaya posibleng naging...
But let's trace it. Saan ba nang galing yan? Paglutang-lutang yan all over Rojas Boulevard or Manila Bay.
Yes.
It so happens, ang may bukas na may yung walang breakwater ay yung harap ng Rojas Boulevard. So lahat ipinasok dyan.
Yeah.
No? But if you will trace where that came from, all of that garbage came from the drainage, no? Mm-hmm. From the waterways that everybody throws into the waterways and ends up in Manila Bay through Pasig River, through Parañaque River. Lumabas lang lahat yan, pero galing lahat sa inland yan.
Ah, okay. So pag inland pa ho nang gagaling yung basura, DPWH concern pa rin ho yun? Hindi na?
Well, LGU and LGU. Everybody's concern. No?
Opo.
That's unfortunate, no? It has to be everybody's concern.
Yes, yes. Well, pagtatapon ho ng basura, hindi na ho siguro makakontrol ang DPWH dahil kung talagang engineering intervention lang po, may magagawa po ba? Yung sinasabi
tama
po na...
Yun. Kaya namin yun. Kaya nga kami naglalagay ng malalaking box culvert, no?
Yes.
To augment the discharge of water, no?
Yes po.
Pero kaya namin tubig lang, pero yung basura hindi namin kaya.
Kasi kanina po, meron pang talk of putting up incinerators na naman nga daw para yung at least yung garbage mas madaling hakutin at sunugin.
Well, that's not also a permanent solution because it also affects, bawal na nga ang open burning ngayon, no?
Yes.
So, there are engineering interventions. A properly engineered solid waste can be done, no? Nagagawa naman yan.
Correct. Mm-hmm. All right, Secretary Singson, we'll have to leave it at that. In the meantime, thank you very much, sir, for speaking with us on ANC.
Thank you so much, Tony. Thank you.
All right, we're not going to get any garbage from this girl. All the good stuff. Lexi Schultz. Telling us what's trending on the internet, what's brewing in the newsroom. Lexi.
I guess it's how you see it, right, Tony? But we have this photo from DZMM.